Hello, my name is Greg Jew with Keysight Technologies here at IMS 2016. So millimeter waves are of interest for high data throughput applications. So today we are showing a 73.5 gigahertz over the air transmission with 5 gigahertz of modulation bandwidth. So the test setup consists of our M8195 AWG. This is a 65 gigasample per second AWG, and we're using one of the channels for an IF source. So this is what's producing our modulated IF, again with 5 GHz of bandwidth. It's being run into a Virginia Diodes Incorporated, or VDI, millimeter wave upconverter, and we're upconverting to 73.5 GHz using this analog MXG as an LO. So at the output of the upconverter we have 73.5 GHz. It is being amplified with this amplifier, filtered with this waveguide bandpass filter. And then we have a horn antenna, and this is what's actually transmitting it over the air, where it is then picked up with this horn antenna and down converted with this VDI down converter, again using an MXG as an LO. The IF signal is routed into one of our S-series oscilloscopes, where we're digitizing the signal and analyzing it with our VSA software. So you'll notice that the constellation is clean. This is showing very good signal fidelity, even though we're transmitting over the air, and even though it's at millimeter wave with 5 gigahertz of bandwidth. If you look at the spectrum, you'll notice that we're doing an occupied bandwidth measurement, which is the measurement shaded in blue here, and the occupied bandwidth is roughly 5 gigahertz, so we're occupying 71 to 76 gigahertz. Let's take a closer look at how we're achieving this performance. Here we have the symbol rate set to 3.7 gigahertz, and we also have a root raise cosine filter alpha of 0.35. So the excess bandwidth associated with the root raise cosine filter and that symbol rate is what gives us the 5 gigahertz of occupied bandwidth. We also have the carrier offset set to 4 gigahertz. This is effectively the IF frequency of the signal that is being generated from the M8195. And I'm going to click on the setup VSA. And this will download the waveform to the M8195 AWG, and it also set up the VSA to perform the measurement. So let's go ahead and bring up the VSA software. And you can see that there is a fair amount of distortion on the constellation, and we expect this with 5 gigahertz of bandwidth. So now what we're going to do is we're going to correct for the linear amplitude and phase errors across this 5 gigahertz bandwidth. And to do this, I'm going to click on this calibrate VSA button. And what this is going to do is it's going to use the adaptive equalizer in the VSA software to correct for the amplitude and phase variation across the 5 gigahertz of bandwidth. And so here the adaptive equalizer has done its job. We can see that the constellation is nice and clean. And when we look at the real and imaginary response of the adaptive equalizer, it's corrected for the linear amplitude and phase variation over the 5 gigahertz of bandwidth. So now let's go over to the receive side of the system and do the measurement. You'll notice a couple different things. The constellation is clean because we've done the pre-correction on the baseband waveform before downloading it. You'll also notice that the EVM is 2.1%. Very good EVM result given the high frequency and the 5 gigahertz of bandwidth. One thing I'd like to point out is that we're also doing an occupied bandwidth measurement. So this is what is shaded in blue on the spectrum. Again, a very wideband spectrum, about 4.5 gigahertz. So we're effectively occupying the entire 5 gigahertz of bandwidth from 71 to 76 gigahertz. Now you might wonder why the center frequency is set to 73.5 gigahertz when previously we'd mentioned we were doing an IF frequency of 4 gigahertz. What I've done is I've gone into input user correction, and I've set up just a mathematical relationship that says we're using frequency conversion, the center frequency is 73.5 gigahertz, and the IF frequency is 4 gigahertz. So we're doing the measurement at 4 gigahertz, but referencing it back to the input frequency in the VDI converter. Millimeter waves are highly directional when they're being transmitted with these horn antennas. And to illustrate that for you, what I'm going to do is just misalign the alignment between the transmit horn antenna and the receive horn antenna. Misaligned, and then here I'm aligning it. Millimeter waves are highly directional. This actually can be a benefit for millimeter wave transmission in being able to reuse frequencies and mitigate the effects of interference. So for more information on this solution, please contact your local Keysight representative. Thank you.